show called Super Fight League. It was not a show, it was a concept where eight girls and eight guys from all over India having different martial art backgrounds come together and fight to survive. So if you lose, you're out. I lost because I had a really bad knee injury and it was a very embarrassing loss for me. So I lost all hopes in life. At 15, I was like, oh shit, my life is...
That's millennial.
Sorry. So, I'm so sorry. So I thought my life is over and I'm out and I don't know what to do. And that's when, I don't know, out of nowhere, Maddie sir spotted me on the show and he was like, who's this girl? Looks interesting. I want this girl. And I was like, okay. I mean, what do you want me for? So he said, there's this film that I'm making. It's called Sara Kharus. It's based on boxing. I'd like you to meet me and audition for it. I was like, auditions? Okay, let's give it a shot. So I just went in and they liked my energy and I don't know what they liked in me. And then they just casted me for the film and then life changed.
I think you've done a fabulous job.
Thank you.
Thank you. But before you run away, I'm going to ask you, would you like to show us the difference between the boxer walk and the celebrity walk?
Did you think that was a celebrity walk when I walked up on stage? Okay. Oh, sorry.
He's so sweet.
Yeah, he's really... Okay, what?
It's a good thing.
Okay, oh.
So how has life changed?
It's still, it has changed. I mean, I have fans and people taking pictures with me and sending me sweet messages. That has changed, but I have not changed. I'm still the same person. I mean, I'm wearing my kurtis with my Converse because I had no heels on me and if I wear heels, I'll trip. So,
that's so sweet.
I don't want to be the next Jennifer Lawrence. So. That's why I did not wear heels.
You don't miss boxing, you know?
I do miss it a lot and when I'm in the gym, I still train. I do shadow boxing with him. He's powerful. Let him be. So, yeah, when I train, it's called shadow boxing. So what you do is, with your hands and your legs, you just punch and kick in the air. Imagine there's someone in front of you. That's what I do when I train, yeah.
And Maddie spotted you where?
In Super Fight League because it's Raj Kundra sir's show and Raj Kundra sir and Maddie sir are really good friends. So that's where he just saw my picture. I was standing like this, you know, giving all the attitude in the world.
Wow.
And that's how he picked me.
He keeps spotting me but he doesn't give me a chance. And so does Mr. Shashi.
Well, you're not Rithik Singh.
I know, I'm not a boxer either. Okay, I should take boxing lessons as well.
Yeah, I'll give it for free. I want to give boxing lessons to the entire world for free, especially women. Take it, I'll give it.
Okay, how many people are signing up?
Thank you.
Congratulations, Rithika.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Oh, before I leave, thank you so much, Brew, for this honor. I'm really happy to be here.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
So how do you, can you show us how to...
So first thing is attitude, okay? Think that you're the best in the world.
Okay.
Although you're not, but then believe it. I'm sorry. I'm the best right now. So yeah. Thank you. So, okay, one leg back, one leg forward, whatever. And just relax. Chin up.
He's always.
One hand up. Good one. One hand up, the other hand up, and just look. Stare into the camera like you're staring into your enemy's soul. Yeah, like this. And just look. And that's it. Thank you.
Go back home and do some shadow work.
Yeah.
Till your wife comes back.
Okay, don't take her into a class, please.
Yeah, no, I will, for sure. Because
she might apply.
That should happen. That needs to happen, clearly.
That needs to happen?
Yeah.
No, I'm so kind of you.
I'm so sorry. I'm just joking. No, thank you. No. Bye-bye. No,
no.
What? Sorry.
Okay. So, to the last award, but before that, I would like to call the round table.
Ever since the evening started with Vivek and Samir, we've not stopped laughing and enjoying ourselves and you give such a light touch to everything, it makes it so special. Thank you, wonderful. Turned out to be a good event, she sang well, and newspapers were just coming up those days, you know, these little local news issues. So someone took a picture of her and put it on that paper and said, there's this wonderful young girl called Patamal and she sings so beautifully. That morning, instead of celebrating, one could hear all the women in Patamal's family, the aunts, the cousins, the elder people, the grandmother, the mother, they were wailing, they were crying. Nobody knew why. And then it turned out that they said, ayyo, namba veetu ponna photo vandu paper la vandirthu, yaar ivala kalyana pannipa? Who is going to marry this girl? Her photos appeared in the papers. So that is where, you know, women were not very long ago. And thanks to her father who supported her, she made the move as an adolescent with him, and then the mother joined, came to Chennai, lived in a little one-room tenement and started life, and then went on to become the legend that she did. So, well, that problem is past now. We women singers of today are standing on the shoulders of those great legends. But we have other issues. As you rightly said, there are still those cobwebs in everybody's head as to, you know, what women can and cannot do, will and will not do. But one thing is for sure, I think there is still this thing, whatever a woman does, sorry, don't get me wrong, but she is still slightly short of being good enough. And that I want to share with my women friends, especially the younger ones. And I'm so happy to see all these wonderful young people, and we're going to award one more young person. They are so full of confidence, so gung-ho, so casual, and so happy about what they are doing. That's what makes my heart so happy, because that's, we never grew up like that, you know. I'm proud. And please empower all those women. You said you want to teach kickboxing. Please do that. All of you, just share. Because there are still those underprivileged young women out there who still don't have that opportunity that all of us sitting in this room, we're lucky. Because we come from a certain strata of society. But there are still those women who don't have those opportunities, and we have to reach out to them.
Of the year, please give it up for them. Congratulations.
So, how did this come along? I mean, tell us about it.
First of all, thank you, Sameer, for having me here, and it's been a lovely, lovely evening. And congratulations to everyone who won the award today. And I feel extremely, extremely small compared to all the magnitude of the achievement that everyone has done in their respective fields. Amazing work, amazing achievers. I think, hands down, it's extremely inspiring. And I'm extremely happy to be sharing dais with all of you, and so many sports people. It's amazing to see that you've picked up so many sports people. It's superb, and I think thank you for considering me worthy of this, and I'm very, very happy that I could make it here today. And thank you, Venkat sir, for this. It was fast, it was super fast. I always trip when I have to go for photo shoots, because it's just a lot of effort, and for whoever who does it, and people who are in front of the camera, behind the camera, it's really not easy. I think it's a whole different ball game. If you're in cinema, you think you know it all. It's just another photo. No, it's not. I think in the past few months I've understood that, because it's just been photo shoot after photo shoot. But this one was special and very fast, and it was for you, so thank you for this. Thank you. And I think Vivek, I think your debut stint has been very, very well received, and you've been great.
You can charge from the next appearance.
It was very...
No, actually he would be paying me a royalty every time you speak because I gave him the first opportunity.
You were really good. So it was a very entertaining evening and thank you for this. So I didn't know there was going to be a sit down conversation. You took me off guard, but...
Even I didn't know.
Okay, that's what you claim to say, but it's okay. And yes, it's been a great honor, and last year has been extremely amazing with regard to work and everything put together. And the whole UN thing came as a huge honor. More than an honor, I think it's a huge responsibility on my shoulders. And if they think that my voice could make a change and would make a change, I think that's the biggest push to do something better from where you stand and from where you come. And if I can inspire, if I can empower, if I can change the way even two or three women think, I think I would consider myself worthy of the part that they want me to play. And we are hoping to make a lot of change. I understand that it's going to be slow, but I hope it's going to be a steady change that we are planning to do. And let's hope for the best in the coming year. March has started off great, and I think this is the best way it could have started off for me. So thank you.
Cinema Weird, which is again very unique because I don't think anybody would have thought about doing a documentary on stuntmen in Indian cinema. Not just that, I think you've probably given purpose to the whole documentary. Again, not many would know here that, okay, the stuntmen that we use in cinema, I mean, cinema sells primarily because of stunt in especially this part of the world. I mean, the action, right? But the National Awards category doesn't have a category for stuntmen. And she has ensured that there is an application, a petition sent to the governing body that be included in the category as well. And so tell us more about it. I mean, how did this, again, where did you pick up this whole idea of stuntmen and what was the...
It's actually a three-part documentary, and the part of the stuntman is the first. And the second part is going to be on junior artists, the life of junior artists and how what happens in and around their lives. And the third part would be about background dancers. So see, these three people, these three sections of cinema, without these, your screen is going to look empty. There is no meaning to your frame. There is no meaning to your story if you do not have these people around. So I thought, you know, being born in this industry, brought up in this industry, I'm married into this industry and I'm working here, so I really can't see this away from me, apart from me. And this is the smallest way I could pay tribute to the kind of work that they do and the kind of significant work that they do, but it goes so unspoken about. So I thought a documentary would throw a little bit of light on the kind of hardships that they go through, yet how beautifully they embrace life and how beautifully they look at the work that they do as more of a collective team effort rather than they getting any kind of acknowledgement out of it. So this is more of the smallest tribute possible to these three sections of the cinema industry, and I think it needed to be done, and I'm happy that I'm able to do it.
Only a few. It's on Amazon, it's in Odyssey, in all the stores, please buy it. I'm doing my little bit of marketing. But how many people know? How many people have bought the book? I think you should do it tomorrow. How, I mean, this is again completely something that you can't imagine, like, okay, you can say that she's directed a couple of films earlier, probably she's directing a documentary, it's fine. But suddenly a book is as simple as, like, you know, I have an apple and I have a pen and I'm going to write a book. So it's like a song, you know, a song, right? It sounds so simple, but writing a book is not that simple, and publishing it with one of the biggest publishing houses. How did that happen again? What was the...
I think the book happened and I'm happy that it did. It was not very difficult to write this particular book because it is more of, you know, pulling pages out of my diary. It was very real, it was very personal. and upfront. It was not about projecting myself as a great author who knows the language, or you know, writing flamboyantly or trying to prove that I know how to write. It was more about breaking the myths around how people think that celebrity kids are born and brought up, and why they think a particular way, why they behave abnormal, and to say that, hey, you know what, we're really not that abnormal. We're pretty normal. We do normal things. We like to eat very normal food. It's not like we need expensive stuff all the time. It's just the kind of way that we're brought up, and just to break the myths and shackles around misconceptions around that. So that's how it started, and it slowly started evolving into a book where it was more of such personal experiences and instances from my life, and it was more of a reminiscing and nostalgic experience for me to write it. So I totally enjoyed doing it, and again, I think I was just blessed to get HarperCollins into this, and they loved what they read, and it all fell in place, and I'm extremely happy that I did what I did, and I think the writer bug has bit me, so let me see, I don't know.
In one of the chapters, I read the book, and you said on your 18th birthday you wanted a gift from your dad, and that was to go see what a discotheque looks like.
I wanted to go to the disco, but I ended up just seeing it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So is the discotheque in this building? I'm just guessing.
No, it's not.
It's not?
No.
Oh my God, okay. My guess is wrong. Okay. So, and about the next film that you're going to direct, a biopic again, Shah Rukh Khan released the first look poster on the 1st of January, which is also a birthday, and then about Mariappan, the high jumper, Paralympian, gold medalist. So again, what's the inspiration? You pick up things that probably, you know, other people, you know, given kind of imagine looking at creating a product or a film. So what was the purpose?
I think biopics have become the flavor of the season right now. So that gave me the push and the confidence to say, okay, why not try a biopic? And there haven't been many biopics. I think there hasn't been any biopic in Tamil at all. And who could be better than our own boy who comes from Salem and who has done such a huge achievement in such a small age. So it's more of a pride to make his film rather than anything else. So that's how the whole thought came. And it was very interesting as we started researching about his life and as we started you know, going to where he lives, where he was born. It's extremely inspiring and also fun in a lot of ways, because we always feel that he's a Para-Olympian, he must have gone through only hardships, but surprisingly that's not how his life was, and that's not his take to life, which is the most positive part of his story, that he never looks at himself as a person who has lost something, who doesn't have anything. He has the most self-confidence, I think, much more than any of us in this room, and he is such a bindas guy. So the character was so interesting to portray, and we're hoping to make do justice to his life and make a good film out of it.
Superstar. I have to. Okay, tomorrow, I don't know how many people know, I'm sure all of us know that Basha is releasing after digitization. Right, we got the opportunity, in fact Madhuvanti was there that night at Satyam, and we got to see it once, like last month. And so one thing off my bucket list was knocked off, because in Satyam, I managed to get on stage and dance when Bhajapara was happening, and then I actually broke a chair as well. So that was like a dream come true for me. And I called Swaroop and said, you know what, I'm not going to pay for it. It was exciting. I mean, it was crazy because the film released after 20 years, and it's the same madness, the same. I think it was just, we were all crazy that night. I went back, I couldn't speak, but I was still thinking about every scene in the film. So, are you going to see the film in theatres?
Yes, of course. I'm going to see it tomorrow at Satyam, 12 o'clock noon show.
Are you going to break the chair as well?
No. I'm not going to break any chairs, but I'm sure I'm going to lose my voice before I head to the UN. So I'm going to keep that in mind and not scream too much.
And the last question is, well, the man, what, I mean, I'm sure you've learned and he's inspired you a lot. What is that one big quality that you think you got from him?
That would be difficult to say. I think I see a lot of him in me, and I can't really put a finger to just one aspect of something that I have got from him. Maybe I would say predominantly the nose. It's something that I can't really get
on.
No, I don't know about that. But this, yes, I know, and I'm not too happy about it. So other than that, I think there is so much. I think it's just by default when you live with someone, you start becoming a part of a bit of the person themselves. So I guess a whole lifetime has been with him. So you do tend to do things the way he does, do tend to think the way he does, which is good because I think he's somebody who is worthy of following. So I believe in that, not just because he's my father. So I think it's worked for the best. So I'm proud of him.
All of us are. Andy, thank you so much.
Thank
that
you.
That was Aishwarya. Thank you.
Thank you, Arnandi, for it was he actually baited.